why countries like Brazil need to invest now in 5G?
It's a very important time out there across the globe for the implementation of 5G. We're starting to see more and more build out, and more countries are coming online with the new networking technologies. You know, it's really important for all countries to move to 5G as quickly as possible, because number one, it's going to provide better bandwidth, lower latency, more connectivity, faster connectivity, and it can also do so in a more efficient way. So the quicker countries are moving to 5G, the better. Now, across the globe, we're seeing different levels and different paces of movement from 4G to 5G, or even 3G, continuing the journey upstream. So again, for Brazil in particular, it's a good opportunity to start leveraging this new technology. And even though 4G is still in the process of being rolled out in a variety of areas around the globe, moving to 5G, at least in your densely populated areas, and moving there quickly is definitely a plus, because it helps with spectrum efficiency and it helps with efficiencies of the network as well. And again, it doesn't mean you need to do that and just rip out 4G and replace it with 5G, because there are step ways to get there, moving from 4G to 4.5G and then ultimately on your journey to 5G. And again, this isn't a one-year investment. It's not a one-year change. This is going to be, you know, at least a decade. Each of these major networking technological cycles are usually in decade increments. So this is a long-term play. And it's not just a cost, it's a long-term investment in the future of the countries and the future of Brazil. And there's a lot of value there, a lot of value in jobs, a lot of value in innovation. You know, again, the sky's the limit. And these are critical investments that need to be made.
When you talk about 5G, we talk about artificial intelligence, we talk about big data, we talk about cloud computing more. What is the change the world? 5G really changes the world?
So I think 5G will change the world. It's not going to change the world overnight. But again, to the ability to implement things that haven't been implemented before. So we've been talking about IoT for a long time. And you can implement IoT with 4G, but depending on what elements of the connected world and the cross-sector and cross-industry ecosystem you want to do, 5G is going to be important. So autonomous driving, you know, some automated health technologies, things that are going to require bigger bandwidth and lower latency. So again, you know, remote surgery, you're not going to want to have any latency with remote surgery. Or with automotive, you know, autonomous driving, you want to keep the latency as short as possible. But edge computing is also important in machine learning, because these are all iterative things that's going to help this connected universe of the future.
When you talk about 5G in Brazil, we are talking so much about digital transformation. Why did countries like Brazil have to do for accelerate digital transformation?
Well, I think there's a few things out there. I think some of the developing countries are actually better poised to move into the digital frontier quicker. You know, they can push the envelope a little bit more than some of the developed countries. So it could be permitting. So again, getting small cells out there quicker out there in the marketplace. You know, cutting red tape. You know, these are all things that all countries have to consider. We call it the need for lighter regulation and lighter government interference. You know, governments play a role in managing the process, but again, to roll out newer technologies, especially when it comes time to newer network technologies, it's important to do this in a streamlined fashion. So the quicker we can get there, the better.
In Brazil, many people has a fear to lose your job with the new technologies, principal with the machine, you'll be changing, you're losing the change to human in the job, in the imprint. What do you think about this?
Well, I think anytime new technology comes along, people are nervous about it. But they're going to have to be retooled in their jobs, because some of the jobs today are not going to be available in the future. But I think that's always been true. There's always a technological step that requires people to change what they're doing from something they did in the past to something new. But again, this isn't going to happen overnight. Autonomous driving is not going to eliminate all driving, you know, responsibility in the short term. Maybe 20 years from now, maybe even a decade from now, that may start shifting. But it's not going to happen overnight. But to think about where you want to be a decade from now or two decades from now, clearly, you know, data scientists, analytics, programmers, you know, those type of skill sets are going to be more prevalent than some of the jobs we have today. But it's no different than when computers started really coming up. You know, people thought they would have, you know, that that would make them obsolete. We've shifted, and we still have very robust employment around the globe.
If you could give an advice to Brazilian government about digital transformation, what would it be?
So my advice would be to think about this on a broader basis. This, again, is a very strategic, critical investment, very similar to infrastructure. So the roads or the telecommunications broadband, it's all critical. So it's an investment. It's not a cost. It's not a cost that you're incurring today, but it's an investment for the future. And the more you invest, the more payback there will be, impacting GDP, jobs, and there's a lot of value at stake with moving towards a better broadband plan. And keep the regulation as light as possible.